Of course, I hope you'll think I'm funny, too. So here's a bit that I wrote for an airline show one night. They seemed to like it so much, I just decided to leave it in the regular show. It's in my first album called Looks at Love and Life. Here's yours truly. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Champagne Flight number 12706654-9OM562171 from Fort Lauderdale to New York City, New York. We certainly welcome all of you passengers aboard and hope you have a delightful flight. I'm your plane commander. My name is Farnsworth Carlson. The crew and I boarded the aircraft approximately an hour and a half ago, and we've been sampling the champagne. The pilot controls for this flight is Captain Fred Smith, just graduated from flight school yesterday. And we're going to take off as soon as he gets up his nerve. Your stewardess is Miss Virginia McNamara, charter member of the Mile High Club. Formerly a hostess in a patrol wagon in San Diego, California. Normally, our stewardess makes these pre-flight announcements, but at the present time, she's in the back of the aircraft, sitting on the champagne, keeping it cool. She's been with the airline many years. Even a ground crew knows her. We respectfully evaluate the fact that many of you passengers have flown before, whereas others of you, this is your first air journey. So we do want you to relax and sit back and enjoy yourself. Champagne will be served in approximately 1 hour. We have the weather report for you. The visibility is unlimited. The weather is impeccably clear. This should be a very smooth and enjoyable flight without any air pockets at all.
Ooh, there was one right there.
Which is very unusual because we haven't even taken off yet. Guess you must have run over another mechanic or something. By golly, that'll teach him to strike. We are now safely airborne. You be down, fasten your safety belts, and you be now smoke. For those of you who care to read, we have magazines aboard. I was reading one of the magazines myself a little while ago. It was terrible about the Titanic, wasn't it? Now that we're airborne, I feel it my duty to tell you that because this is the inaugural of our champagne series in flight, the duration of this flight will be 14 hours and 35 minutes. We're not attempting to establish any sort of a speed record, but we have so much champagne aboard that we have decided to take the long overwater route. There will be a momentary delay now while our flight engineer crawls down through the belly of the aircraft and disengages a fence which seems to have gotten hung up on the landing gear during takeoff. Along with a couple of old television antennas. Somebody's missing gun smoke right now on the gun lamp. When we reach 20,000 feet, we shall go under pressurization. This is done only as an added comfort to you, our passengers, so when we attain the altitude of 20,000 feet, our stewardess will be by with a little cotton to wipe the blood out of your ears as we go through this altitude. Our true ground speed at this time is 207 miles per hour. Our true airspeed is 212 miles per hour. We have a slight tailwind. She's at the back of the aircraft sitting on the champagne, keeping it cool. Now, those of you who are seated on the right-hand side of the aircraft, if you'll casually look out the right window there, you'll notice that both engines on that right wing have completely dropped off the airplane. It is due to faulty maintenance and will be reported as soon as it returned to the base. And as I told you, there's nothing to worry about because our plane captain, Fred Smith, just graduated from flight school yesterday and he remembers all of his emergency procedures. If I can only get him to regain consciousness. Passed out when the engines fell off. We've raided the head of the Coast Guard. Our present position is 182 miles due east of Palm Beach, Florida, out over the Atlantic Ocean. We've raided the head of the Coast Guard. They have a cutter located 29 miles due north of Havana, Cuba. Under normal conditions, this Coast Guard cutter should reach this scene in approximately 4.5 days. Upon impact with the water, one of these floats roughly 52 seconds. So that Coast Guard cutter ain't gonna do us one damn bit of good in the way you look at it. But I just thought I'd tell you about it on the way down. And as a group of passengers, you certainly are to be commended because there's been no mass hysteria or anything else. You've been a tremendous group of passengers. As your plane commander, however, I feel it my duty to tell you to strap yourselves in securely and we must prepare for a water landing. You need not put your cigarettes out. I'm sure the ocean will take care of that without too much trouble. There, now we're in the water. That wasn't bad. You expected a big, large bump, didn't you? Now, please do not run up and down inside the fuselage of the aircraft because it makes the water burble underneath and we'll sink that much sooner. Our maintenance engineer has just informed me that some miserable Halloween prankster cut holes in all the life rafts, too. And a dizzy steward has just called up, wants to know when she just served the champagne. She even over in the water yet. But you have been a wonderful group of passengers. No point in reading any of the magazines now. They're getting soggy. Can't play checkers because they keep floating away. We ought to get a sensational write-up in Life magazine, though, if they get to us in time. But it appears pretty doubtful now. The water's up around our chests. I see we've lost some of the shorter members of our party. But you've been a wonderful group of passengers, so as we all go down together, hold your heads up high and repeat these words after me. Booze is the only answer. Now, you know I'm only kidding, of course. Flying is still the safest way to travel, especially at night. Very, very few women drivers up there. Now, hang on here a minute while the automatic changer changes automatically. And talking about flying...